Twitch Studio is one of those programs that is overlooked all the time, and the truth is, it is probably the easiest way to get into streaming in 2022. And today, that's what we're going to be talking about. From the download process to starting stream, we're going to talk about it here in this video. Seeing as you're just getting into streaming, you're probably going to be looking for some overlays and some emotes, and my friends over at own.tv have a great offer for you. If you go and click the link in the description, you're going to be able to go and see all of the things from overlay packages to emotes to avatars to badges, everything that you're going to need to upgrade your stream and make it in a very aesthetically pleasing experience for your viewers. If you use my coupon code at checkout, which is Cyrus, you're going to get 50% off your entire order. So make sure you click the link in the description to head over and pick up your new overlay packages and all of the things that they have for you today. So the first step in this is that we actually need to download Twitch Studio, and it's actually in beta right now. So the link for this is in the description, but it's just twitch.tv/broadcast/studio. It's not very promoted, but what you're going to do is click download now and go ahead and save it, install it, and then you're going to get a window that looks like this once it pulls up. So now I've got you inside Twitch Studio. Everything's been installed. I'm actually going to hide this camera on the right just so that you can see everything on the screen, but just know it'll be popping in and out here frequently. So I'm going to go ahead and hide that. And we're going to talk about this interface in its entirety. And we're going to start with kind of each side and what we can do. So let's talk about the right side and then go left. So the right side, if you've ever used your Twitch dashboard, these are things that you would normally see. Things like your activity feed. These are your followers, your subscribers. They all pop up on the right side. Then you also have your chat. That's pretty self-explanatory. This is where people are going to be talking to you. You can go ahead and activate any of your channel point rewards if you are affiliate or if you are a partner. This is where you can still edit any of that stuff. In the middle is your stream preview. And just as an FYI, you can edit these panels and move them wherever you want. This is just the default, but this is where the stream preview is. This is the main workspace, and I'm going to leave it pretty large today just because I know this is what we're going to be looking at. And then above that, you have all of the things that, again, you would see in Twitch Studio, like a session timer, how many viewers you have. But in this case, you have new things like how much CPU Twitch Studio is using, what upload speed you're doing, how many frames are being dropped through your encoder, how many are being dropped normally, and how many are being slow because of CPU or GPU, and then how much memory Twitch Studio is using of your system. These are good things and a quick way of just telling how your stream is doing by looking at this. And then over on your left side, this is kind of the important area. This is the scenes, and this is where also we're going to have your editor for several things. So we're going to kind of walk through setting up a couple of scenes, talking about the different pieces here, and then moving forward with that. So for right now, I'm actually going to change my capture to here so that you can see me. And we're going to do this very quickly and talk about just a couple things before we move into the editing part. On the left side, this is cool because a lot of people have this problem in OBS and Streamlabs. They want to know how to quickly switch between their games, but right up here, under main screen share, you can easily click this, choose what you want to do, whether it be your display, a specific window, in this case, some capture cards, or let it be automatic. You can just quickly choose between it. Like, I want to show Twitch Studio right now. Good. I want to show, like, this is just my edit, my Chrome tab. Or if I wanted to quickly switch to just showing my second monitor, which right now has got OBS on it. Really easy to do that. I can switch between this. And I think this is something that could be implemented in OBS or Streamlabs OBS to make life so much easier. But for right now, I'm just going to leave it on the capture card that I have so that you can see me here. And we're going to next talk about editing some scenes, because the one you're seeing is the main scene. And there's three other scenes, or two others. You have a Be Right Back scene, okay? Real bland, but something that's there. And then you have a Just Chatting scene, which is blank. So right now, we're just going to focus on this main scene, and you guys can do all of the editing on the other two after you see some of the basics here. So we're going to click edit on this main scene, and it's going to take you into this editor, the easy space to work with. You have some controls right up here at the top, like your pointer, you have a crop, you have a snip, you have duplicate and paste. And then on the right side, you have what the scene name is. And then on the left side over here, this is actually the different scenes that you can quickly choose between and edit them. For this one, we're going to edit the main scene, and we're going to go from alerts first your webcam or stream cam next. And then we're going to talk about what your background is going to be behind it. And then we're going to talk about browser sources if you wanted to add in stream elements overlay, or if you wanted to add in media, like if you bought a package from own.tv, used my coupon code to get 50% off, this would be a great place to stick this stuff in. So alerts first. Alerts should already be added. If they're not already added, you can just click add layer and choose Twitch alerts, and then it will add a layer for Twitch alerts. But right now I have one added, so you can right click any of these and just click delete or rename if you want. But this is alerts, and on the right side of this panel, you've seen it pop up, everything you can edit from the duration, the background, you can change border, brightness, contrast, there's so many things, green screen effect. There's so much that you can do just with this one panel, resize it, etc. But you also get the test. So let's go ahead and test what a follow looks like. And this is what we see. It's got a pink color behind. You can see that the host has this kind of tealish color behind, raid, subscription, cheer, all of these things are here. And once you click them, you can change the image. You can go through all of the things that they have already pre-built in, or you can add what you have into here to be able to use. For example, all you got to do is just upload them, put them in, and that's done. You can change the accent color. You can change the actual sound, whatever the case. So this is a great way to be able to quickly edit your stuff and put it into Twitch Studio for your alerts. Once it's done, it's all saved under that alert panel that you can easily move around, etc. And you can move this around too. You can resize it, make it as big as you want. Like, there's my alerts. Let it take up my entire face. It doesn't really matter, but I usually keep my alerts kind of small and towards the bottom or up towards the top so that it doesn't take away from the screen, but the people get recognition doing what they've done, whether it be raid, cheer, post, whatever the case. So alerts are set up. That's done. Let's move into our webcam. Now the webcam in this case is down over here. And for this video, I went ahead and set up my Skycam, which is, I guess, Skycam, so that we can see this other webcam happening. Once you click webcam on the right side, you're going to see so many things pop up, from what is the device that's being used. It's over here, by the way. What the device is being used. You want to debug it. Do you want to add a green screen effect? Do you want to do color filters? So I'm going to go ahead and show you. I'm going to hit change, and then you can do your drop down box to be able to choose. Like, I have a webcam, a bunch of OBS cams, NVIDIA broadcast, which I could choose NVIDIA broadcast and it comes through, but I'm going to choose this T2S webcam, and you can see that's my Skycam up top. But this is the cool thing that I love about Twitch Studio, is not only do you get to choose your webcam, but you're actually able to do filters and go through here and choose what kind of fits your webcam the best. Like, I really liked this faded too. I felt like it added a good bit of texture to the picture. It's really nice, but there's a bunch of different options. There's Pro 2. These are things like almost like LUTs in a way. Pro 2 looks really nice. Vibrant looks really nice. And you can see there's so many options here, and you can be very, like, I don't know, very specific on how you do this. I'm going to land it on Pro 2. I just think that looks great. Down there in the corner, real easy. I can change so much about this, like the border, and just make this what I would like it to be. So let's go ahead and look through a couple of things over here on the side. For example, we can change opacity, green screen, brightness, and contrast. We also have the border. So when we click edit border, we could change this color. I like a blue because that's kind of where my brand is. So I'm going to change mine to a blue. And that's done. I have a border, a webcam. It's already been set up. I can resize it. The border stays with it. Like, no problem. That's great. I can shrink it down just like that very quickly. Like, resize this to where it could be just me on the screen. There's so many things you can do with this to make it unique. And I think it's a really great, really great thing here. So webcam is done. I'm going to go ahead and put that back down in here in the corner and just leave that right there. And let's talk about what's in the background. So there's two things. You have game captures and display captures, but really they do the exact same thing. Okay. So for right now, I'm actually going to delete game capture because I think it leaves, or display, I think it leaves game capture as soon as you get started. So what you're going to do is you can click edit, and for right now it's got game capture selected, which is my HD60 Pro, which is what I run my webcam through. You're curious about that, I have a mirrorless camera, Sony ZV-10, which is what I use, and I'm running that through there. And so what I could do is just choose anything, like my entire screen and have it like multiply this a whole bunch. I could choose my specific game, which will pop up here as well. I don't have a game running, but let's just say I'd choose Chrome, which is where the Twitch Studio piece is. That's done, right? Again, if I choose something that doesn't fill up the entire screen, like a small window, like my second monitor, this background that's already here is something that is already applied. I think in kind of like a basic set, you have this wallpaper. You can change that. There's a whole bunch that you can choose from, etc. Let's say I like this one right here. It's great. You choose something that's smaller than the full size, it'll compensate it by putting this wallpaper here. If you don't like it, you can always click show layer and hide it. You can lock things too, so you don't move them. But regardless, this game capture is kind of what's happening. What is your game that's happening on the screen? So we're going to think that this is done, and I'm going to go ahead and click save. And technically, I would be ready to start stream from this point, except for audio and testing that stuff. We'll get to that in just a moment. But right here, we're going to click entire screen, and I'm just going to click the game capture so that we can see that this is done. That's it. All of this is set up, but now let's talk about audio. We're going to go down to the bottom left and of the screen, and you're going to see this audio mixer, and it's going to give you the choices as to what you have. You have things like, what is your primary microphone? What are your individual audio sources, etc. This is where you're able to choose what your audios are. And if these aren't right, you can just click the little gear and you can choose what your microphone's going to be. So you can change your default mic to whatever you would like. And then you can add things here, filters like compressors, noise gates, suppressors, all from right here. All of this is done. And not only that, you can actually click exclude the source from clips and VODs. So if you have things like Spotify playing, for example, I'll just go ahead and pull up Stream Beats and have that playing in the background so that you can see. Like here's Stream Beats chiptune. I'm going to turn it down, but I'm going to click this and you'll hear a couple of those things coming through. I can click add audio and I can choose, I think it's Wavelink music. Yeah, cool. So I'll go ahead and click Wavelink music and that's coming through. So Wavelink music is my Spotify. And if I turn that up, you'll be able to actually see it monitoring right there. But I can click the gear and I can click exclude this source from clips and VODs, which is great. Because if you don't want that to come through into your final post, whether it be going to YouTube or edited down, but you don't want the music there, or you just don't want it to be in the end, the final recording as far as a clip or highlight, this is a great option. Once we've gotten all our audio selected here, all of that's great. You can actually get ready to go ahead and go live from where that is, but there's a couple things left to edit. It's going to take you through at the very beginning all of your bitrate and all of that stuff. But if you didn't or you want to edit any of that stuff, you can just click settings in the bottom right and you get all of your normal kind of things from OBS if you've used that before. If not, you have general, which is kind of your account, etc. But then you have stream quality. You can do smart tuning or you can change these settings. For this case, you can actually choose like 1080p 60. You can choose what frame rate you want, how much bit rate you want to send, and what your encoder is going to be, whether you use X264, in my case, NVENC. And if you want more controls, you can always click advanced overrides and turn on things like cycle visual. You can turn on stream delays, whatever the case. The choice is yours on how you do this. My recommendation, unless you're a partner, I would just go ahead and stream 720p 60 and just let it do its settings here. I know that sounds weird because you want it to be the best quality, but if you don't get transcoding, you want people to be able to watch your stream. They don't want to have to watch it 4 meg download constantly. So 720p 60 or even dropping this to 720p 30 and moving your bitrate to 3500 wouldn't be a bad idea. Next couple things on your stream settings. These are things like what you have in your Twitch, kind of like your settings in Twitch. Things like disconnect protection, latency modes, do you want to enable clips, etc. Recording, I will say this, don't do FLV, do MP4. It's not like MKV. Just hear my, you know, take my word for that. Audio, this is where you're able to edit all the things that you have. Hotkeys, like being able to start and end your stream or change scenes and you don't have something like a stream deck, this is a really good way to do that. Transitions, this is things if you had a stinger transition. They have things in here that are already done, like basic ones where there's none, that's just a cut. or you can do things like special burn ones, or you can do kind of interesting things that are happening. This is where you're going to choose what your transition is going to be. If I can just give you some advice, if you don't have a very powerful computer, stick to none or just fade, something like that. The more you add in here, like this water drop one, it's going to make things run a little slower. I just recommend sticking to none, maybe sticking on one. And this is something that's really cool, and I haven't messed around with too much, but I will go ahead and say this. The in-game overlay is pretty cool if you know how to use it and your computer can run it. This is where you're actually able to turn this on and put it in the top left or top right, bottom. You can actually make it show your chat, show your activity feed, stream status, whatever you would like on your main screen while you're playing your game, and it be completely unobtrusive and no one on your stream will see it. But you as a person with maybe a one monitor setup would be able to do this very easily. I'm going to turn my webcam back on so that you can see that. This is where if you have just one monitor, this is a really good way to keep things consistent. And the way this is recording, it might not show it if it's that way. But whatever the case, I would recommend that you go kind of play around with this. If you want a dedicated video on if this works or not, jump in the comments and I can show you. I know Streamlabs OBS has a really good one as well. This one is something that I've seen work several times on other people's kind of videos, but haven't personally used it. I would encourage you to go take a look at this one. And the last thing is just simply starting your stream. So there's two options. At the bottom, you can click start stream, or you can click the up bear arrow and just click record video, and it will use your streaming settings to do so. I have my face on here three times, so I'm very sorry. What you can do is if you click start stream, it's going to ask you to input all of that information, and then you can just click go live. So what you can do is primary screen share. You can go ahead and choose what your background is going to be, what scene you're going to start on, what is the notification that's going to be sent to your people when they have their, like, they have follow notifications on, etc. And then you can also go ahead and click edit your stream info, change your title, what's your category, what, etc. You can change all of this stuff before you go live, and then you just click go live. That's it. It's done. And that's pretty much Twitch Studio. There's only a couple things I would recommend you doing to make sure that your studio experience is even better. And this is what I'll go ahead and recommend. At the very bottom of the screen, I'm actually going to right click Twitch Studio, the actual icon that I'm going to launch every single time to launch Twitch Studio. And I'm going to click properties, and it's going to take me into this window. And from here, I'm going to choose advanced, and I'm going to click run as administrator. And some people might think that this is a weird thing, but the truth is we want Windows to prioritize our stream over our game. If you do it the other way around, you might get more frames in your gameplay, like what game you're playing, but your stream's going to be choppy. So the question is, do you want to sacrifice the stream for your gameplay, or do you want to sacrifice some of your gameplay for your stream? So if you check this as run as administrator, Windows will automatically prioritize this, just because the way Windows reshuffles things, it prioritizes games every single time. So I want you to make sure that you check run as administrator so that you have a nice clean stream. Click apply a bunch of times, and that's pretty much it. So if you have any questions, make sure you jump in our Discord, discord.gg/thedarkness. I would love to answer any of your questions. I'm sure I've covered everything in here that makes sense, but if you do have questions, please make sure you jump down in there. Check me out over on Twitter /DarkenCyrus or @DarkenCyrus. And that'll bring us to the end of this video. If you're looking to upgrade your setup and maybe pick up a capture card to use with Twitch Studio, check out this playlist that I'll link over here to a bunch of capture cards that I recommend, as well as including a bunch of examples. I'm Brandon. Welcome to the darkness. We'll catch you in the next one.